Hello everybody, welcome to 将棋ラーメン TV. いらっしゃいませ。Let's enjoy 将棋 with me. Today, I will introduce one of the interesting 定石 of 横歩取り。This 定石 is very intense and there are many branches. Let's see one by one. This is the basic openings of the 横歩取り。And in this position, there are many possibilities for the 後手。And today, I will introduce this king move, 4-2 king. This is the interesting way for the 後手。And against this king, if the rook move here, the game will be the stable. But today I will introduce this move. This move is the very aggressive way. And from here, there is branches. So the 定石is taking the pawn by the rook. So the first branch is the What happens that taking the bishop? It looks nice attack because of the dropping the bishop next. If the rook take the knight, this bishop can take the silver and break the castle easily. But in this situation, rook can back to here. This is the nice defense for this position. So the Bishop cannot take the silver because the gold can take it. So the 後手 can drop the pawn, but the rook can move here. So in this position, and for the 先手, it is difficult to use the rook, but the 後手 has already dropped the bishop, and it's looks even or a bit better for 先手 because 先手can drop the bishop in the any place in the future. So the taking the bishop is not so good. Taking the this pawn by rook is the way. And from here, next 後手 can take the bishop and gold or silver cannot take because the rook can take the gold or silver. So the next move is nice move. This is the attack to the knight and it looks risky because the bishop exchange and drop the bishop for the check and rook. But in this situation, if the 後手 take the bishop, this rook can take back. So it's okay. So the 後手 needs to defend by this pawn. And the dropping pawn is an interesting way to continue attack. And if take this by pawn, rook can promote and it's better for 先手. So the moving the gold is basic defense against this pawn and take pawn and take by silver. So it looks difficult to break this defense because the silver and gold is very strong to the defense. But there is an interesting way to continue attack. Exchanging the bishop and drop the bishop here. This is an interesting way. And it looks difficult to continue attack after I escape the gold. But there is an interesting way. So dropping the pawn is a nice move. If the 後手 take the bishop, 先手 can take the silver. This position is better for 先手 because the There are no good attack from the Gote, but the Sente can attack by using the promoted pawn easily. So the this promoted pawn will change with the gold, and this position is better for Sente. So against this dropping pawn, there is a good move of the bishop. This bishop is a check and attack to the rook, so it's very strong bishop. And against this bishop, this move escape the king is the best move. But let's see another way. Move the gold. This is an interesting way. If the bishop take this, take rook, gold can take the rook or take the gold. So sacrifice of the rook first, it looks nice, but it's very risky. So in this position, Gote has one more gold, but Sente also can take the gold. And which king is more in danger? So for example, the Gote can attack by rook, and this dropping rook looks strong, but in this situation there is already checkmate from dropping the rook. Escape the king, drop the gold, take, take, and promote the bishop. Escape, drop the gold, escape, and take the silver. It's long, but checkmated. So this kind of the Yokofudori game, very intense. Joseki is there. And against this gold, not take this gold is the best way. And Sente can take the rook, but Gote can take the bishop. This is better for the Gote. So the indecision, taking the gold is the best way. But Gote can escape the rook and take the knight, and Gote promotes the bishop. This is strong attack need to defend by using the piece. And take the silver. This is also very intense branch. And it's still difficult situation. Sente can drop the knight, but Gote has already many strong pieces, rook and gold. So this is also the even branches. So the let's back to the main branch, main stories. Against dropping the bishop, this escape the king is the best way. And take the rook by bishop, and take the gold, and take by silver, and dropping the pawn is the interesting way. If the take this pawn by silver, bishop can promote here and attack to the silver and knight. But there is an interesting move. Move the rook. So in this situation, Sente already dropped the pawn, so the Sente cannot drop the pawn for the defense. So the need to move the silver and drop the rook this position. This is interesting way. Against this rook, this is bishop and rook attack to the disposition, so the need to the defense of the disposition. Defense by the silver is the best way, but the Sente can move the rook here. So if the defense by gold, it looks nice because the silver can defend against this rook, but there is a nice move. Drop the pawn. This is a nice shuriken. And if the taken by gold, rook can promote here, or bishop can promote. And if the take by silver, rook can promote it. So this is better for the Gote. So the protect by the silver is the best way. And in this situation, this rook force the silver to move here. If the silver was there, silver can move here. But in this situation, silver is here. So the only way is the protect by silver. And it's difficult to defend this position. If the gold here, Gote can drop the pawn. And the center has to attack. This is the best scenario for the Sente and the Gote, but it's still difficult to continue attack or defense. And there is another interesting branches. So I introduced this pawn. And there is another interesting way. Dropping this pawn. So against this pawn, what is the good point of this pawn? It's against dropping the bishop, Sente can drop the pawn. And this is attack to the rook and for the, of course, the defense. You take the rook and Gote succeeded to take the bishop, but the Sente can take the silver and create the promoted pawn. So this position from the Gote. It's difficult to attack, continue attack. There is no high speed attack. But from Gote, from Sente, there is a strong attack by the knight who drop the rook. So in this position, it's a bit better for the Sente. So the against dropping this pawn, best way is the sacrifice of the rook. Because this rook has been taken by pawn, so the sacrifice is the better. And dropping the bishop. This is the best way for Gote. And the king needs to escape. Drop the gold. If the escape here, Gote can drop the rook in the future. In this situation, the Sente can drop the rook to attack to the king and the bishop. But the Gote also can take the silver. This is also difficult situation. And this bishop is nice. This is attack to the rook and attack to this pawn. But there is a nice strategy, dropping the pawn. And from here, there is no good attack from the center. But the Gote, it's easy to attack to the king. Move the gold here, or gold here, or drop the bishop to surround the king. So the in this situation, it's better for the Gote, a bit better for the Gote. Okay, so I explained the intense joseki of the yokofudori, and there are many branches. Let's see. So in this situation, the exchanging a bishop and dropping the bishop is not so good. The take the pawn by rook and move the rook, drop the pawn, and defend by gold, take, take, and exchanging the bishop, drop the bishop, and escape the gold, and drop the pawn here, then drop the bishop, and escape the king. Take the rook, and the gold, drop the pawn, then move the rook. Defend by silver and drop the rook. This is very nice rook. And defend by silver and move the rook again. Take, take, take. Okay. This is the main story, but there are many interesting branches. Okay. Thank you very much. See you next ramen. Bye bye.